Hello students, good morning. As we have already started a topic differentiation, we have already done rules for the differentiation. We have also done the product rule and the quotient rule in our previous lecture. In continuation with that topic, today we will discuss another function, implicit functions. Now, as in the differentiation, we will always consider the functions there. So, for the implicit functions, functions are of two types, explicit function and implicit function. Explicit function we have already discussed, in which function is in the form of y is equal to fx. Or you can say that if we separate the terms, we can separate dependent variable one side and the independent variable to the other side. For example, x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0. If you shift the term, you will get y is equal to 1 minus x. But for the implicit functions, x and y are related to each other in such a way that it's very difficult to separate x and y. But if we separate them, then we get a very complex functions. Or you can say that we can't separate the variable easily. I am taking one example here. X square plus y square minus 1 is equal to 0. If I am shifting the value of x square to one side, y square is equal to 1 minus x square, y is equal to plus minus under root of 1 minus x square. Now in this term, you are having two roots. One is for the positive and the another one is for the negative. In this case, you have to solve it for the two functions there. So it's difficult to solve with simple way. Now in this way, we are having some working rule for the implicit functions. According to that rule, number one, we will write down the given expression. Number two, we will differentiate both sides with respect to x. Number three, we will shift dy upon dx term on one side and the other terms on the other side. By simplification, we will get dy upon dx as the answer. Now, keep it in your mind. Differentiation of y with respect to x is dy upon dx, or you can say that ddx of y is dy upon dx. Now, I am taking one example to understand this topic there. I am taking an example in which if y is a plus sine y is equal to cos x, you have to find out the dy upon dx. How to start this sum? Solution. We will write down the expression as it is given there. Y plus sine y is equal to cos x. Second step, differentiate both sides with respect to x. As we differentiate the term, differentiation of y is dy upon dx plus sine y differentiation is cos y. Now it's term of the angle there. So ddx of y there. Cos x differentiation is minus sine x, ddx of angle, angle is x there. As we solve the equation, dy upon dx plus cos y into dy upon dx. Differentiation of y is dy upon dx is equal to minus sin x. Now, take dy upon dx as a common factor there. 1 plus cos y is equal to minus sin x. As you collect the term, dy upon dx is equal to minus sin x upon 1 plus cos y there. Now, I am taking one more example to understand this topic. In this example, x cube plus 2xy plus y cube is equal to a cube. You have to find out dy upon dx. Now only dy or x you are consider here. So a cube is the constant term there. You write down the expression. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. Now ddx of each term there. Ddx of x cube plus 2 constant term. Ddx of xy plus ddx of y cube. Ddx of a cube. Constant term differentiation is 0. X cube differentiation is 3x square. 2 as it is. Now, xy is the multiplication form. Now, we will apply the product rule here. X ddx of y. First function ddx of second function plus y ddx of x there. Differentiation of y cube 3y square into dy upon dx. 3x square plus 2 by applying arrow method. And separate the term of dy upon dx there. Dy upon dx, collect this term here, left hand side, dy upon dx 2x plus 3y square minus this one. dy upon dx, by shifting the value, you will get this answer there. Now, I am taking one more example of t ratios there to understand this type of expression. If sin square x plus cos square y is equal to 1, in this case, you have to find out dy upon dx. Now, again, differentiation with respect to x there. We have write down the expression there. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. As degree is there, we will solve degree first, then its term of the t ratio, then angle there. Then when we solve the degree, 2 come first, sin x. 1 degree is there, now its term of the sin x, t ratio. Same way, cos square y. 2 term, 2 cos y. D dx of cos y. 1 differentiation is 0. 2 sin x. Sin x differentiation is cos x. Now its term of angle. Angle is x there. Same way, cos y differentiation is minus sin y. This negative sign changes sign there. D dx of angle. Angle is y. So differentiation of y is dy upon dx. Now whenever we solve the equation, we will get that 2 sin x cos x minus 2 sin y cos y dy upon dx is equal to 0. Now, we have already learned this formula. 2 sin x cos x is equal to sin 2x. Same way y angle is there, so it will be equal to sin 2y. Now by shifting the value dy upon dx to the left hand side and the rest term to the other side. Negative and negative sign cancel. You will get the answer dy upon dx is equal to sin 2x upon sin 2y. Now students, you will receive one related link and RoboMate module link also will be there. Go through that links also and do more and more practice related to this topic. Your 11.2 exercise is totally based on this topic. I hope you people will do. Thank you.